And like that you said as well, that we're not alone.
We're not.
Like sometimes we get into this robotic phase, starting to feel like we're an artificial intelligence. We're not. So we just need to realize it. And it just, it takes me to this quote I'm currently looking at, which says, let go of what you can't control, but empower yourself to affect change by focusing on the things you can do.
Hey, hey, people, it's your girl Esther Ray, and this is Not Format Village People.
I think perspective is actually a gift. It's a gift to have a different perspective to the other person you're having conversations with, and it just makes it all interesting, isn't it? So on this platform, we're going to share personal stories. Be open-minded, listen in, pick what you can pick from it, do you understand? On different topics, because we're going to be talking about different topics, from friendship to marriages to life happenings to growing up to backgrounds to careers to businesses. So different people will be coming on this platform, and I'm looking forward to sharing my perspectives, my stories, and exciting informations just for you to learn from it. It won't be new things that you've not heard before, but I'm hoping this platform will serve as a kind of a reminder for you to connect back to that you need to connect to. Once again, it's Not Format Village People, guys. Thank you.
Hey, my people, it's your girl Esther A, and I don't know what I'm doing behind this Blue Yeti microphone, because I obviously cannot go to bed right now. I can't even sit down and binge my new obsession of desperate, what's it called? Housewives of Atlanta. I'm catching up on some of the seasons or episodes, or even find another Black Mirror episode or season to watch. But because I went back to work, crazy me went back to work after I've screamed it for so long that I need to get back to work. I'm tired of being in PJs. Maybe what I should have done is just find a time, find a day, just wake up, shower like every other normal human being, get my makeup on, put on a shirt like I'm going to work, maybe put on my heels around the house and just get cooking, doing the dishes, cleaning, taking care of the little one. Maybe that notion of me thinking I have to go back to work before I can do my makeup in the morning and put on a shirt, maybe I would have saved or helped myself of that particular thought or mindset. But jokes aside though, I'm so happy to be back to work. I love what I do. I think yesterday being my first day, when you're listening to this now, it will probably be after a week or two or three or so. When I had a moment and I thought, oh my goodness, I see what people say when they say I am actually compliance obsessed. I'm in compliance. I work in financial service institutions, making sure the compliance with all regulatory requirements when it comes to money laundering and terrorist activities and things like that. That's what I do. And I manage a couple of teams. And I remember dreaming to myself, or unrealistically saying to myself before maternity, that after maternity, I'm going to go back to better than what I was doing before. And you know what? Just speak it into existence is what you've got. And I'm grateful to God that I got what I wanted, you know, setting up a whole team now. But the thing is, sisters, misters, I'm not drowning. I refuse to drown. It's only the second day today. Behind this Blue Yeti microphone, I refuse to drown. But today, I'd already planned to record another episode with one of my amazing girlfriends. But then we got on the call and we're like, you know what? We just started catching up and things like, because I've not even seen a beautiful face in a while now, in weeks. I think in about 2 months, isn't it, girl? I think I've not seen you in about 2 months. So we're catching up like that. And I thought, do you know what? And she said, you know what? We can actually talk about experience of going back to work after maternity leave, because she's got a 2-year-old now. And I remember she took some time off as well, you know, to do this maternity thing. So today we're going to be on here ranting about this motherhood boss lady movement, because girl, if you're listening to this and you're in our shoes and you're thinking, you know what, I haven't got it together, because that's feeling today, I'm feeling like whoever said I'm organized, they lied, because they are part of my village people. They lied to me because I'm not. Anyways, before I continue, you know, I will do this
all night. I've got my girl here, and we're going to be talking about some amazing things when it comes to the impact of change in our lives, especially as women, as the sisters. And hopefully some misters that will be clicking into this episode to listen will understand the struggles. Like, seriously, honestly. And I wanted to do justice by introducing herself. I don't want to tell you who she is, what she's about, what she does for a living, but you know, I wrote where, you know the kind of people I roll with. I'm always bragging about my friends. And this is another boss lady. When you talk about boss of bosses, she's a boss lady. Hi, girl. How are you doing?
My head is swallowing already. I'm so happy to be here. I'm super, super excited. So hello, everybody. My name is Adeola. I'm a certified Scrum Master by day. Agile coach, I'm a trainer. I've got quite a few certifications, less practitioner as well. I currently work as a senior Scrum Master for a robotic process automation company. And in the evening, and when I'm not doing my day job, I'm the founder of Meta Insight Consultancy. So I'm one of the trainers for the company where we offer comprehensive Scrum Master training courses. We do that in co-ops. We focus on those seeking a career transition, mainly into IT. I've got some other side hustles as well, including Amazon FBA, et cetera, et cetera. I'm super, super excited to be here tonight.
Thank you so much. You see, I don't move with village people. If you are village people and you're still in my circle, I need to find a delete button and delete you. Delete. Because look at my girl. Look at everything she's just told you that she's about, and she does. Honestly speaking, we try. We try. Don't we, Adela?
We're trying.
We can, you know, just to try and get out of the battles.
Don't want to do it. It's like, just can't not do it.
You know, it's not us. We are hustlers. You know, we do our in a good way. We do our stuff, you know, to get by and to make sure we're giving our children the best. The best. Takes me to my very first dramatic situation about this parenthood situation. Do you know, I remember before I had my first child, when people talk about, oh, kids are expensive, I really couldn't say anything much about it. But I remember having my first one and I'm like, oh, they lied. Kids are not expensive, especially because I ended up with a first daughter that hardly ate anything and like that. She wasn't very picky but sisters, now I know. Then now I know these kids are expensive.
They're not cheap.
They need to be coming with their own type of job so they can bring some money with them when they're arriving to planet Earth. But yeah, jokes aside, anyways. But you know, it's not for my village people if we don't start with our regular. So it's a quotable quote that we're going to look into. And I was obviously, before hitting the record button, I was discussing with Adeola and she's got a lot to say about it. So listen, and hopefully you'll be blessed. Don't expect change to happen overnight. Even if it's not always visible, it's making more impact than you think. Sister, tell me, what does that mean to you in your perspective? Break it down. Let's understand from your perspective.
So it means a lot to me, actually. But looking at it from the perspective of the topic we're talking about tonight, which is change when you go back to work after maternity leave. But it's just like you're experiencing a new normal. And all the feelings you're feeling is normal. You know, your feelings are valid. But the thing is that we expect that change to happen overnight. We expect that I've had a kid. And whether you're a man or a female, because men as well, responsible fathers out there, not throwing shades or anything. When you're there to support your partner, you know, through that journey, that is massive. And then going back to work after that, you will feel that, you know. So give yourself grace. Don't expect to have normal or whatever normal was to you before you had a child. And there will be different between when you have your first child and then second and third and fourth. And every time there's an addition to your family, expect that change. But then also remember that you matter, the impact that you're having on your company, on your organization, and on everybody around you matters. So it's like, even when it's not visible to you, because sometimes you feel like, am I actually even doing it right? Do I know what I'm doing? You feel overwhelmed, but you're making a massive impact much more than you realize or you think of. So that's kind of like my initial thoughts on that. And I'm only saying this now, like going back after 2 years. But if you did ask me as well, my first day back or my first week back after mat leave, it was just like, no, I don't want to do this. I want to just not work. But at the same time, I love what I do. So yes.
So going on to, you know, let's talk about the unfair part of things. I remember I said earlier, and I said last year, because with my first child, I think I've mentioned it on this platform already, that I went back to work, I think 5 months after I had my first daughter. Obviously, some of the connection part of things had to do with that as well. Even though, you know, again, colored people, do we accept? I feel like we know it now. We know better now. We're trying to do better. But yeah, talking about postpartum depression, I probably just did not give myself the opportunity to be in that. But my mom, that lives miles away from me, she notices it from the kind of question I was asking her. And she was really happy that I did not really have the same effect on with my second child. So she said, oh, it's different this time around for you.
Yeah.
And I remember then I ran back to work, which one of the reason was, you know, one of the reason I was able to do that, my husband did a paternity leave. But this time around, the second one I really wanted, obviously after everything I went through before having my second daughter now, I really wanted to have the maternity leave. And I kept saying to myself, I'm going to stay home for a year. Again, people, this is just even just digressing for a little bit. What you put out there, it happens. So say good things to yourself. I said to myself, I want to spend a year maternity at home. And I kept saying it last year, even before the baby arrived. But then in February, I was looking at the pocket. I was looking at all the goals I set for the year. I was looking at all the partying, all the traveling.
Big year.
All the enjoyment I have planned into this year. I shoved into this year. Like, you know, like 2023 has got no backup plan for 2024.
I didn't come to play.
You understand? And then I started to look at my pocket and I'm like, oh, at home and finances. And I'm like, February, I want to go back to work. So I started to apply for work in February. Bear in mind, guys, you know, I'm a career coach. I am the career coach, sourcing job for people. And February, March, April, May, I think by May, I was like, girl, maybe it's time I go and look for some type of jobs, because what's happening here? But yeah, my industry, the industry I work in has been quite dry lately. And it was just a struggle to get in jobs. So when I eventually got this job and I've started this new role now, second day in, the first day when I was a bit overwhelmed, I was thinking to myself, I don't even have the right to cry. I wanted to do water work. I don't even have the right to complain. I posted a picture on my WhatsApp today and I sort of felt, I cringe a little bit from posting it, because I feel like some people that know me well and we've talked about, you know, me looking for work, we feel like, oh, you were looking for this job. Now you got the job and you're complaining about it. But I'm human.
You are, and your feelings are valid. That's one thing. And sorry to interrupt on that.
No,
is
go on,
the
go
expectation
on.
We set ourselves. And there's been a research actually by, I think it was Tenor, that did that research, that we as women naturally would set our expectation for ourselves. And one of the tips from the research is lower your expectation. Many people return to work and they consider quitting due to high expectation for themselves. And because we feel like, oh, I need to come back feeling the same. I need to be even on top of my game. I need to not feel like, because I've had a child, I don't know what I'm doing. You have all of those expectations, but no, we need to chill. And yes, you were looking for the job, you know, we discussed it and everything as well. But then when you're in a situation, that was another thing. The thought, even with the old pregnancy and having a baby, what you think is not always, when you're in it, is like a different reality. It's a completely different thing. Yes, we want to be positive. We want to have that positivity and put things in the universe. I believe in the law of attraction. I'm a Christian as well, but it's like reality sometimes can like shock you. But then the thing is that remember, you've got this. That's like the main message tonight, like with everything we're talking about. And I've come to realize that there has been time when I've cried, you know. There's been times when even before I logged into work, I'm knackered. I start work at 8. I do 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. Monday to Friday. And I do the school runs in the morning. And then I come here, come back to my computer to log in and 7:50. And I'm just like, I'm so tired. I just want to go back to bed. I just feel so overwhelmed even before you start. So you need to find ways of kind of like staying grounded, or the things that have helped me anyways.
Yes.
Nice cup of tea, drink water, give yourself that time to breathe, to gather your thoughts, you know, and just to say, I've got this. Affirmation does help as well.
Yeah.
And just give yourself grace to adapt to the newness.
Yeah.
Because your normal is different now.
I take it in. I receive it. I receive it. Especially what you say, your normal, what did you say again? Your normal is?
Your normal is different now.
Your normal is different now. But I am is of the mindset for those, you know, it's a new company as well that I've gone into. It's not like a company I was working with before maternity. And I'm coming at a different capacity than I'm used to. So my goal and what I coach all the time as well is you want to create your wow effect at the beginning.
At the start.
The start of it. It's not that I'm not creating it, or but it's a lot. It's a lot because yesterday, today, now I've been in meetings back to back, and there was a period. Obviously, my husband did the school run. I did in the morning, and then he was picking up our daughter. He works from home as well, and he picked up. He was picking up our daughter, our eldest daughter, from school. So my little girl has got to be, you know, somewhat close to me, but I'm in back to back meeting. Like I'm in back to back meetings, trying to get to know my stakeholders better.
Yes.
And then she's there in the other room, and she's crying.
Yes. And then you get the mom guilt.
Oh my goodness.
You get the mom guilt.
She's crying and I'm here trying to like, I need to listen in. They need to see that I'm listening in. I've invited them to this meeting that I want to get to know you better. So someone can help introducing themselves to me. And I'm like, oh, just give me a second. My 8-month-old is crying in the background. I can't do
that. Then that is okay. That's another thing. That is okay. And that's one thing I've to learn and accept and say, this is part of me. I'm not just a scrum master. I'm not just a coach. I'm a mother as well, you know. And you know my story. I'm a single parent to two amazing boys. So it's like I've had to put things in place. Like currently right now during the session, I've got a babysitter in. Yeah. She's lovely. She's amazing. She's my lifesaver. So you put things in place. But then there are situations when I've had meetings and baby Anu's been off sick or something, and I've just had to put him on my lap. I've had a CEO playing peekaboo with him whilst I'm doing presentation. And I felt the first time that happened, I felt so awkward. You know, I was like, oh my days, they're going to think less of me. That's the thing. You have all this preconception in your mind. And like you've clearly, you've said, it's your first week. You want to create this wow effect and everything. You're creating it. The fact that we're there, we are already a wow
effect.
And it's take now that I'm talking, that I'm still like hashtag working in progress. It's not like I'm not there yet. There are certain days when it still happens, when on Fridays it doesn't go to nursery, and when the babysitter is not here, and you're in between that meeting, you're in the middle of that presentation, and it was happening that, but you can air him upstairs, but you're like, okay, I'm just going to finish this slide, and then I'll tell people that I need to pause. Or you
feel
that?
Do you do that?
Yeah, there's been occasions when it's happened.
But why am I thinking out loud now? Because I know you went back to your previous organization. You were pregnant
with this company.
They knew when you had the baby. They understand. But I can't even remember if these people know. I think it wasn't a point for them. This whole role is a miracle situation where there was no interview. It was just someone, a recruiter that knew, oh, yeah, this is you.
That contacted you.
Go and solve their problem. And I came in and like,
awesome.
You know, he said this about you. We just want you to come in. So I didn't need to do any selling or telling.
Yeah, exactly. So you've already got the wow effect.
I don't think they know his name, my old baby.
But then that's the thing, though. We think because of the image and the perception, what me personally anyway is like, oh, Adela has to be this certain way. If it's not that way, then it's not right. Or, but I'm an agilist. That's another thing what Agile has taught me. We need to be flexible and pivot where needed, you know? And it's not just with work, it's with life generally. You know, there are certain times when, like, oh, my to-do list, you say you wanted to, I'm going to do this today, but you can't always get around to it. But make your work visible as well and set expectation and boundaries. You know, those are the things that kind of like helped me as well. But it's all about realizing that, like I keep saying, the word I keep coming to my mind is that your normal is different and give yourself grace for this season, you know, and just get through it. It's like another tunnel in life. Life has loads of different tunnels, you know.
Honestly,
This is just another tunnel in life. But like you said, you don't even have to, you didn't have to sell yourself. So you're, it's probably more like difficult. Let's call it what it is, in the sense that because what you've just shared now, they've sold you, you feel like you're on a pedestal and you feel like you need to show.
Thank you for that.
I feel you. I feel, because when I went back as well, I went to a new team. A lot changed because I was off for, we grew from when I left, I think it was about 10 teams. And when I came back in a space of 7 months, they've grew to 16 teams.
Just imagine.
There's been a, there was a lot of restructuring. So I had to get in into a new team, two new teams, and everybody, there was loads of new people, and I had people saying to me, oh, you're the amazing Adela they've been talking about. You're Adela that did this. And I'm like, okay, Adela that can't even remember a password.
No, I don't have anything to say to that because no.
Can't remember anything. I was
Oh,
just like, okay. How do you even facilitate? Oh, Angela, we want you to facilitate this. We heard that you did this workshop. Remember that workshop that you did? They were Fingy recommended you. I was like, who is Fingy? Who recommended me? The imposter syndrome starts to kick in.
sister, I feel like
Syndrome
imposter
starts.
syndrome has moved in now. My desk right now, I feel like
Yeah.
I've got 4 chairs on my, surrounding the desk I'm using currently. And I feel like imposter syndrome has just decided to duplicate themselves and just sit around me right now.
Yeah.
Because, like you said earlier, they're looking at this person, oh, this is a savior. She's coming to
Yeah.
fix it.
To fix it.
Every meeting I'm having with any stakeholder is like, oh, we've heard about you. So yeah, so this is
Yeah.
there. So this is the issue. This is this. And I'm like, oh, we're creating this. Let's create this. Oh, let's create this. Oh, that's fantastic. Oh, I can have this ready. I will da, 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 da. And then I'm like,
Okay.
and
Yeah.
I'm like, okay, when is bedtime? It's not gonna happen. My husband
Yeah,
literally
that's another thing.
he came in yesterday, even though we talked about it before going back to work, because they know I can be crazy when he's back to a 9 to 5.
Workaholic.
With my business, I have my, oh, I can set up my calendar and say, okay, no, I'm not working, I'm not available during this time, but not with the place where I'm supposed to come in and create a wow effect. And he came in
Yes.
like, and it's just the first day yesterday, but he was like, the only woman I know that would work from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. It was not a nice feeling. It was not a nice feeling because I actually want to be, a woman that also starts at 9 and closes a laptop at 5. But I do not have
Yes.
that luxury right now.
Yes. Right now, you probably don't, but then it doesn't mean you cannot create it. And with more you have, the more you have to manage it and manage expectation and set boundaries. Boundaries has been my buzzword. Yes, we want to create that wow effect. People are expecting a lot of us, but then there's only so much you can give. And there's this lady called Lauren Curry. She's amazing. She's the founder of Upfront Global. I did a confidence course with her. And one of the things she mentioned or she promotes is about giving from an overflow as opposed to from empty, basically. And in order to do that, there are certain guardrails you need to put in place because you've gone in, or we've all gone, especially as women working professionals, we have so much expectation. People expect so much from us. But what are we feeding ourselves? Are we looking after our mental health? Are we looking after physical health? Because all of this thing, there's always a cost. In Agile, we cost something. Project management, they'll have you as well, cost of delay. But not just cost of delay. You need to think, what's the cost of me not sleeping? Before we went on air, I was sharing the joke about Starbucks. I need to get franchise with them. It's so bad that they know my order. It's just, I pull up in the drive-through and I start saying it and they'll complete the order for me.
So, that's something else.
You know, there's that aspect. But then after a while, you want to look after yourself so that you want to ensure that you're sustainable.
Yeah.
Because like I said, things have changed. You've got two kids now. I've got two boys. You've got two amazing girls. So it's like, what are the boundaries I'm putting in place? And that will include my work time finish at 5 or 6 or whenever it is, or 4. And I close that laptop. And it's hard. I'm not going to lie. It's hard. And you just have to do it. Yes, there will be occasion. Me talking now. I've got a workshop tomorrow and I haven't finished and I'm still going to do a bit more. Every now and again, yes, it's to be expected. But we cannot continue to deliver at a consistent, steady pace.
At the detriment, of our family.
Yes, we need to deliver at a consistent, steady pace, not like big bang and doing all of that, because like we said, yes, we can't let it be at the detriment of our family.
Yeah.
And it's different, you know. When I was just thinking, well, when we're talking about two kids, so being single, got married, everything, I had my first child, felt like I went back to work too early. So the second one as well, I was saying, whenever I was to have my second child, I'm going to stay for a year, but then life happens and stuff like that. Again, I went back around 7 months. So going back, the first one, it was different. But the second time, it was like there was more. This baby brain thing is the real thing. That research that I was referring to earlier as well, it actually does take about up to 6 months when you go back from mat leave. This is what the research says.
Up
the
to
survey 10,000 mothers. Yes, about 6 months. You're like, what? I don't have 6 months.
I don't have. I have a month, a day, 2 days. But I get you though. I get you.
Yeah, awesome. Another thing I wanted to mention is that I know we've been talking about how it feels going back to work and feeling overwhelmed and everything, but it's like we're not alone. And that was another thing I found, that when you talk to other people, that you feel like they've got it all together, because that's another thing. We try not to compare, as much as we try not to compare, and like we've got all this expectation of ourselves. You'll be like, oh, but that person can do it. They were doing it effortlessly. You see, like some days, I'll be like, oh my days, thank God I'm working from home, because baby food all over my dress.
Sister.
You know, but then we're not alone. Everyone is juggling through that as well. There's the good side as well with me, because I'm a single parent, going to work, you can have adult conversation. So I actually look forward to that, you know.
Yeah.
There's fun aspects of it. And it's just a phase. It will ease, but we need to help ourselves to make it work for us. And what works for A might not necessarily work for B. And what works for child one might not work for child two or child three or child four or how many children that we have. So we need to just give ourselves grace for that. And it's hard. It is hard. I'm never going to say it's easy, because it was hard, but it gets easier. I think it gets easier. You just get used to it and you find different coping mechanisms.
Oh, thank you so much for that. No, honestly. And I like that you said as well that we're not alone.
We're not.
I feel like sometimes we get into this robotic phase, starting to feel like we're an artificial intelligence. We're not. So we just need to realize it. And it takes me to this quote I'm currently looking at, which says, let go of what you can't control, but empower yourself to affect change by focusing on the things you can do.
I love it. I love it. Came across that quote as well. Like, it was when I was helping one of my students with interview coaching, and we're talking about strengths and weaknesses. And I was like, oh, but I've got this weakness. And I was like, why are we focusing on weaknesses? Focus on your strength.
Right.
Focus on what you can do. Like, for example, with me now, I know I'm good at facilitating. You know, that's one of my superpowers, an agile coach. You're a badass PM, everything, you know. Let's focus on that strength.
Yes.
But then the delivery might be slightly different. It might take us a bit longer, but that's okay. But let's focus on the strength that we've got as opposed to the negativity and everything else around.
Amazing. Oh, thank you so, so much, Atiola. You have no idea. Yeah, I guess it was just meant to be, you know, sitting there and recording this right now and talking
we're
about
just talking.
No, to be fair, I feel like sometimes because we all have this expectation. At the end of the day, I will say it again. She's the career coach. She shouldn't be struggling.
I'm like, that's the thing, is the expectation is the story we tell
ourselves. Struggling. I feel like I'm my sister
and
coach.
Do you know what? Even admitting that is awesome. And thank you and well done for doing that, voicing that out. Because some people might look at that as like something negative. It's like, how can a career coach be struggling? But we all have struggles.
100%.
You know?
Yeah, 100%. Yeah, with this so-called wow effect week. But I'm still going to do it. But again,
doing it.
Oh, bless. Thank you. Thank you. I really appreciate that. I'll just make sure, like this says, I will let go of what I can't control, but empower myself by affecting change, by just focusing on the things that I can actually do.
Definitely.
What I can't do today during the working hours can be done
working
tomorrow
hours.
And if it can't
Definitely.
Be done tomorrow during working hours, it will be done the day after tomorrow,
the day after. Exactly. And another thing, that confident course that I mentioned earlier with Upfront Global, Lauren Curry taught us, was celebrating every win. And you even promoted it, because I've taken a few of your coaching sessions, is having that brag sheet, pull it back up again, pull that brag sheet up again and put it on there. Everything, the fact that you even log into work, like I mentioned before, 8 a.m. I feel like some days I'm like, I'm going back to bed, but then turning up yourself should be celebrated.
Yeah.
So, celebrate every wins, no matter how small.
I love that. I love that. I love that. And when you said as well that the fact that you're there already is a wow effect, so take that.
It is.
Take what you saw. Take it.
Definitely.
Oh,
yeah.
Focus on
that
virtually
positivity.
Hugging you. It's sending you so much love. I love you. Thank you so much for this.
Too.
And like I said, people, not for my village people, it's a platform where you would come and you'd be reminded that you're not alone. So whatever
We're
it is,
so
and I
alone.
Know, you know, talking from a career coach perspective now, I remember I had a call the other day from another lady that was looking to get back to work after maternity leave. And it was waterworks between us. I'm sure she didn't know I was in tears with the story she was sharing.
Yeah, she was sharing.
I like the expectations. You're looking, you left for pregnancy as a boss lady. You wanted to come, you want to come back. All I ask for is come back as a boss lady or even a better boss lady. Because after all, I've had a baby come out of my hoo-ah. So you should be the queen of all queens, right?
Exactly.
Great. But then you get there and you're like, no, the lady that I spoke to that day, she had to resign when she went back to work.
And that research shows it as well, the pressure. Yeah, because you feel so overwhelmed.
It was just
well.
Too much. She just couldn't handle it. And she was, I think one of the things she said to me was like, I'm just trying to look for who I was before pregnancy. And I just couldn't hold it. I was crying. Like, you won't find her. She's nowhere. She's gone.
With Evolve. That's the thing. And there was a podcast I was listening to today, actually, about we evolve.
Yeah.
And we need to realize that change also brings evolvement. Hope that's the right English. In the sense that who we were, like I keep saying, our norma is now different. And we need to accept that. That in itself, that can be painful sometimes, because it's like, even now, like me that used to wear platform ridiculous heels, I can't now. Is it
just
because
try it,
you're
just try
holding
it.
One child, you're trying to get another one in and everything.
I know.
But I still put in my bag. So when I'm in the office, if I do need to. But now rock trainers, you know, be comfortable with that. And another thing, that brings me to the what I wanted to say about adaptation.
Yeah.
We need to find ways to adapt to the current situation. So had a colleague of mine who just had a baby as well, a male. Well, his wife had a baby. So he just came back from paternity leave. And whilst he was on paternity leave, he was always messaging me, like, how do you do this? This is hard. I haven't slept. The baby, we took it for a walk and he's now not feeling too well. I was like, oh, just do this, do that. You'll be fine. You'll be fine. And then when he went back to work, the first thing was like, Adiola, how do you do this?
Oh,
It was like, so that's even from a father's perspective.
not a
So
mother.
it's for both mother and father, the change, it happens, and we just need to adapt. And one of the things it brought up, that one of the challenges that I was having, is that he's more of a nocturnal person and he read and study outside of work and everything. I was like, get audiobook. It was like, what's that? I was like, you've never heard of audiobook?
Oh,
So
bless.
audio is our best friend, it's my best friend. So he messaged me later, was like, oh, you made me get a tablet. I was like, you wanted to get a tablet before anyways, but an excuse. So it's finding new ways to adapt, getting help and support
Find
as
new
well is
ways.
very, very important. Find new ways to adapt. If you like reading hard copy book before, get that book on Audible. If you just shift your workload around, and get help and support as well. We want to be that wife material, that mother material that cooks every day, fresh fruits and veg. Success.
I think mine is the gym. I've not been to the gym now this week. I remember on Monday when I woke up and, with everything running around trying to get both girls showered and dressed.
Ready.
Yes, too much information now, but I think I spent 7 minutes in the shower yesterday. Today, I don't think I spent 10 minutes in the shower this morning. So you know what? At some point this week, I need a scrub. I need a proper scrub, maybe on a Friday. But
It's
yeah,
so
like,
funny that you mentioned that. There's some days when, because I'm rushing and everything, and I'm like, have I brushed my teeth this morning?
you forgot.
All these things are real. I know we're meant
No, that's
TMI, but
real.
we're on
No,
here.
you're not
But
alone.
we keep
You're not
it
alone. But yeah,
real.
no,
We keep
this was
it
really
real.
good. This was good.
But give yourself grace. Let's continue to give ourselves grace as parents. Whether your father, your mother, you've got one child, you've got two, you've got three. I mean, regardless of how many you've got and you're working, even if you're not working and you're stay-at-home mom and you're listening to this, let's give ourselves grace. We're doing a great job, and no matter what we're doing, whether staying-at-home mom or whether working or having businesses, we're doing great.
Amazing.
And the
Thank you
fact
so much.
that, we're doing.
Oh, thank you so much. Sorry to call you short there. Thank you so
It's
much.
okay.
Really
You're
appreciate you
welcome.
for being here. I'm sure I'm gonna drag you back on here. This has been
Let's do
great,
it.
honestly. And while you said you mentioned a few names on there of the things that you're doing that has been helping you. For the love of Huddable Books, can you tell us one book that is doing it for you? Maybe right now did it for you at some point, but that our listeners can actually go and you know what? I heard it on that podcast and I'd like to read that book. What book is doing it for you or did it for you at some point?
There's a lot, but two that came straight to my mind is The Light We Carry by Michelle Obama, and was a Viola Davis book as well.
Viola Davis. Oh yeah, that's it was no, Michelle wrote Becoming, right?
No,
Viola
the
wrote.
second one. So Michelle Obama's second book is called The Light We Carry. That is an amazing book. And Viola Davis' book, I'm just trying to find the name now. It's just gonna have my head for some strange reason. Finding Me by Viola Davis.
Finding me. That's
Finding
it.
Me
That's
by
the one.
Viola
That's the
Davis.
one.
And The Light We Carry by Michelle Obama, and
Who I will
Becoming as
carry.
well.
Yes.
And
What
why
food?
those books did it for me is because these are women that I see as my role models, and they actually talk about what we're talking about tonight in their book as well. The impact of change and how they've had to adapt, and all the ups and downs. Like Michelle Obama, she spoke about when missing a children's play or the mom guilt that she had, and then going back to work, getting her mom to pick up the kids. She had to move her mom in with her when they went to the White House because she was like, she doesn't know how she's going to cope. And Viola Davis as well, a struggle with having a child and everything. And when she did have that child, again, you're like, you prayed for this and everything, but she still had to get
Can't
help and
manage it.
support.
That's me 24/7 with the guilt. Like, oh Lord, you know, everything I went through to have that baby, I can't complain that I'm actually not managing well, but I am not.
Yeah. But that Michelle Obama as well, she had the lay, and I didn't know until when I was reading those books. Mm-hmm. And the thing is that the more we talk about this thing, the more we empower ourselves. As I'm talking now, I'm empowering me, you know, and those women is kind of giving me that courage because they were able to go there, you know, talk about it, bear it all. Yeah. I was able to do that. So amazing. I just thought I'd share it today.
Oh, but thank you so much once again, Adeola. Like I said, guys, you've heard it all. You know, you've heard it all. Oh, she's come here. She's done justice to that. And I hope you listen to this and you share it with a friend, a sister, a mister that is kind of struggling right now with either paternity leave or maternity leave, just so they know they are not alone. And you don't have to be, you're not a magician, you know. Give yourself grace. Give yourself grace. It's a new normal for you, and your normal is different. Impact of change is real. So please, self grace. Thank you once again for coming here today, Adeola.
Thanks for having me.
Share this, follow us on all the platforms out there that you may be listening to this, and drop your comment. If you have a comment, if you have any questions you want to ask, if you have any special, any person you believe I can bring on this podcast as well, that you would like to hear from, or you want to come on yourself, please feel free to send me an email on notformyvillagepeople@gmail.com. And by the way, we now have an Instagram page. Now, I am working on catching up with posting on that place, and I think it's one of the things I would need to assign to someone in my team very soon. But again, guys, please go out there on Instagram, follow us, share our page, and I love you. You know I love you, and I will always say thank you. Thank you so much. It's Not For My Village People once again, guys. Take care and have a great day or night.
Thank you.
But whenever you're listening to this.